Welcome back to the Stop the Hey Girl podcast. Happy Tuesday. I know that the hot topic lately has been Reels. We've already covered Reels, so today we're going to be talking about Instagram stories. And I know some people may have forgotten about Instagram stories, but not you, because you know that Instagram stories are one of the most important ways to connect and build relationships with your audience. So today we are going to be talking about some of my favorite tactics that are super relevant for the end of 2020. To get more people viewing your stories. Because yes, as Instagram adds more and more features and more capabilities, it seems that our attention is being pulled so many different directions and there's only so many hours in a day. So what can we do about it? So when it comes to Instagram stories, the biggest trend that has shifted, so we'll start with that, was having a consistent thing that you were known for, right? So for a lot of people, that was posting their journal covers, that was posting their Keurig coffee on a boomerang every single morning. It was, what coffee cup am I going to pick? That was a trend in 2019 and early 2020. And what has shifted is not the consistency piece, because consistency is one of the biggest things behind consistent loyal views of your Instagram stories, but it's also about what people are coming to look for. People are coming to different features of Instagram expecting more and more high value. And if they're not getting value and not getting what they've come for, they're going to leave. So what are people looking for when they're consuming video content? There's two main things that they are looking for. The two E's, for the sake of making it simple. They want entertainment and they want education. And for different audiences, these are going to mean different things. You might have also noticed the increase of YouTube viewership, which had dipped in previous months or year over year, is actually steadily shooting up. So video content is still king, but how can you take the fact that YouTube viewership is going up and apply that to your Instagram stories? Vlog style content is doing very well on Instagram stories. But here's the thing, it's not just about showing people your dog or your cute kids anymore. They also want to come for the education or the entertainment. And so I already hear you, I'm sitting at home doing nothing. How can I be entertaining? Entertainment is different things to different ideal clients. So the first thing you wanna make sure is you're researching, what is it that your ideal client finds entertaining? Do they have a particular sense of humor? Like for me, some people in my audience can appreciate some good crude humor. And they can also appreciate goofy things like pranks, like public pranks, like with the fake snake on the string, and they can appreciate and laugh at some of that stuff. So it's lighthearted, nobody's getting hurt, right? But think about your audience and what do they find entertaining. So what are some things that you can share that relates to their sense of humor? Maybe they like the husband versus wife pranks. And so if they think something like that is funny, how you can bring in stronger viewership on Instagram stories would be showcasing more of the dynamic between you and your partner, or you and a close friend that you guys can kind of, you know, witty, bounce ideas off of each other. The consistency piece and the humor and education piece we've covered so far. So people want to know that they're going to see that type of value consistently. So what else do they find entertaining? Entertainment, really, and education can kind of go hand in hand. As an example, in my audience, people really appreciate reviews on things when it comes to home decor, kitchen items, beauty, and makeup. Like, we're not professionals at it, but we can appreciate some good recommendations. So my audience finds it really entertaining when I come on and give my opinion, ask their opinion, and talk about different things with beauty products. Like on my desk right now, I have all of these nail polishes, right? And so I've been posting, asking people, hey, which color should I wear? And then I went on and said, hey, this is a terrible paint job because I don't know how to do it, but the nail polish is good. So that's what you hear clanging around right now. And so when I ask opinion and talk about things and give reviews, my audience, the story views shoot up, because they know if I'm talking about certain products, they're going to find recommendations that they can use and in turn buy. And also when I post about products or asking opinions, my DMs explode, where I get to have really exciting, genuine conversations with people in my audience about products and things that I enjoy. So we've got entertainment, education, vlog style content, Pay attention to humor and pay attention to what they find valuable. What else comes next? Mini trainings have never gone out of style, and actually on stories, they're even more important. So what is a mini training? A mini training is basically when you're coming on and teaching people something quickly. If you're going to be long-winded, like I am right here, this would not be best suited for Instagram stories. This would be best suited for a long form content such as IGTV, podcast, or YouTube. So what would be an example of a mini training? Let's say you want to share a quick chicken recipe and you want to break it down enough for stories. Tell us what we need, right? Our supplies in one slide, how we cook it, and how we serve it. You notice how I like to do things in threes. When you teach something in a form of a three-step system, your audience is able to ingest it that much easier, which makes it best suited for Instagram stories. So when you go on Instagram stories, if you want to teach something longer, give us one tip about it instead. But if you can keep it short, keep it under a minute and a half, put it on Instagram stories. So as an example, my three steps to increase your views on your Instagram feed. Number one would be posting to your feed 3 times a week. Number two would be using niche hashtags. And number three would be a very powerful hook that stops the reader in the scroll and brings them in. That is an example of a very quick, very intentional, to the point mini training. And I try to do these at least 3 times a week, but sometimes, especially when I'm gearing up for a launch, you will notice that I do these at least 5 to 6 times a week. And the reason why you want to get your audience used to high value trainings is they will come to your stories consistently and out of habit to look for them, right? We talk about how it takes 21 days to make a habit. So if you train your audience and they know that they are going to see entertaining and educational content on your stories, they're going to impulsively come looking for it. Have you ever opened your phone, you were going to call your mom, and the next thing you know, you're clicked into Instagram and you're watching stories? That's not, I mean, it is an accident, right? But there's a reason why that happens. Your brain is trained to know that when you pick up your phone, it's gonna take you where it thinks you wanna go. And so that's what your audience will do. And when they consistently watch your stories over time, your story bubble will go to the front of the line. So you notice how all of this works in kind of like a feedback loop here, that you bring your audience in, they consistently watch your stories, they start to look for your stories, and Instagram keeps showing your stuff to them. And so that's how you build up consistent viewership over time. So of course, when you do this, you're not gonna get 100, 200 more views overnight. It's all about training your audience to know that they're always going to get entertainment and education from your stories. Something else as well, here are a few other tactics that I wanna give you, because you know I bring the high value, on how you can get more views on your stories. Change up the types of content that you are showing. So something else that's performing really well are animations. So you can make animations in Canva. I've been using them lately when I'm launching, and they're super easy to post, and my audience really loves them because of how the movement is on the screen. It's super engaging. Another thing is text style infographics that build on each other. So let's say you want to share something to stories that is very text heavy. If you post the story clip 1, 2, 3, and each one you add a new section of text that gives the brain time to take in the information, and they're able to ingest it very powerfully, even if they're not watching with audio. Another tactic is to make sure that you're always subtitling your stories. I know you're busy and maybe lazy. Here's a quick tip to help. Use your voice to text button and just talk, and it will transcribe it for you, and then you can just fix it, post it, and you're good to go. Another tactic that can help get more views on your Instagram stories is completely just throwing up all the social proof from time to time. Strategically, this makes more sense leading up to a launch, right? When you're a week to 2 weeks out from opening cart. But if you wanna spice up things in your stories, share to your stories when people ask you questions, when people DM you to tell you how awesome you are or how much they love your content, when you get a compliment, when a client has such a powerful win. When you share those, it tells people, wow, people who work with Kayla are getting such great results and they're having such awesome wins, I'm going to keep watching her content so that I can hopefully get some of that to rub off on me and I can have wins too. So Instagram stories is such a powerful tool, and even if your viewership is down, if you follow these strategies and tactics, you are going to find that your views will consistently increase because your audience knows that you bring strong connection content, entertainment, and education. Thank you so much for hanging out with me and listening to the podcast. I will see you next week. Don't forget to take a screenshot and post this on stories, because I will share your tag and put you in front of my audience, which, by the way, is another powerful way to get views on your Instagram stories when you cross-pollinate between audiences. So tag me, I will share it, you can share it back, and that's another way that you can get more views. I will see you on next week's episode. Have a great day.